We say hello to Mike Maniscalco. Mike, Curtis McElhaney, as I just mentioned, he's been good for this Canes team as of late. The team places Scott Darling on waivers yesterday. What do you make of this goaltending situation as it stands right now in Carolina?
Well, I think what we make of it right now is Curtis McElhaney. What you said, he's got the numbers, and Rod Brind'Amour said it. Not only that, he's producing wins. And his teammates to a man, and most notably the captain, Justin Williams, talks about Curtis McElhaney, what a calming influence he's been for this team. And when we look at the story, he gets picked up in October after Toronto puts him on waivers because Scott Darling, who looked great in the preseason, tweaks his groin the last preseason game. And all Curtis McElhaney has done is step in and do what he's done pretty much his whole career. He's been calm. He steps in the pipes. He's consistent. You know what you're going to get out of him. On the other side, it's tough for Scott Darling because he had such a good preseason, Jackie. But the Canes, after they waived him today, he's down in Charlotte. He's accepting that assignment, and hopefully he'll find his game. But the reason why this move had to be made, you just can't carry three goaltenders as long as the Hurricanes were doing it. At some point, it becomes unfair to all three of the netminders who are here. So that's why the move was made. And as Rod Brind'Amour has preached since he's taken over as the head coach of this team, if you earn your minutes, earn your ice time, we're going to keep rewarding you. And Curtis McElhaney has certainly done that for this hockey club.
Yeah, I guess three's a crowd. It's true what they say, right?
It's not three's not company when it comes to trying to play goal in the National Hockey League.
Yeah, exactly. Well, some tough news for the Canes. Today, Micheal Ferland placed on IR with a concussion. How tough is this loss going to be for the Canes, considering everything he's brought to the team this season?
It's a big loss for a few good reasons. One, the goal scoring that he's brought to the team with 11, but most importantly, the toughness. It's been an element of this team that's been missing the previous few years. And Micheal Ferland is a guy that the opponents hate to play against. And not only that, it disrupts the top line of Sebastian Aho, Teuvo Teravainen, and Micheal Ferland that had great chemistry pretty much from Jump Street for this season. So at least today, we're going to see a reunited line of Jordan Staal centering for Teuvo Teravainen, and Sebastian Aho moves out of the middle and goes back to the wing. Rod Brind'Amour was a little coy about that, saying that that might be the line that we see, but there's some familiarity there. But, you know, it shakes up the lineup, and it takes out a really big presence, a guy who has been everything that the Hurricanes needed as far as a big power forward who can protect other players, and he's got a whole bunch of skill.
It's been an interesting season for this team as well. I mean, they start the year as a bit of a surprise team, playing really well, racking up a ton of shots. Then they dip a little bit, don't play as well, but they've picked things up as of late, winning 6 of their last 10 games. Is there an area for this team that you've seen most improved over the last little bit?
Well, Jackie, it's two areas, and it's one of the reasons why we saw the dip. It was the penalty kill and the power play. They were at the bottom of the league in October, and now for the month of November, the penalty kill is in the top 5, and the power play is middle of the pack. But when you consider it was near the bottom of the league, that's huge for this team that was struggling to score goals and struggling to find a way to get those 5-on-5 goals. Now when you can count on chipping in a man advantage goal, things kind of open up a little bit more for the offense. But the penalty kill, really, that was the big surprise, because it's been so good in Carolina the past few years, but they were really snake bit at the start of the year. A couple of bad bounces, a couple of bad breaks here or there, and pucks were going in on the net when the Canes were trying to kill off a penalty. But that's really turned around, and I think that's why we've seen the Canes start to pick it up a little bit here in the last 10 games.
Well, the Hurricanes put a ton of shots on goal this season in every single game they play, and the Ducks allow a lot of shots on goal, so that should bode well for the Carolina Hurricanes. They're both in action against each other tonight. Thanks for this, Mike.